Didn't Joseph Smith claim the Book of Mormon to be the most correct book on earth?
Yes, that quote is found in Joseph Smith's History of the Church, Volume 4, page 461. Quote, "I told the brethren that the Book of Mormon was the most correct of any book on earth, and the keystone of our religion, and a man would get nearer to God by abiding by its principles than by any other book."
I find it interesting that today's Mormonism has precepts and teachings that are not found in the Book of Mormon. In fact, many of today's Mormon doctrines contradict the Book of Mormon.
How so?
Doesn't today's Mormonism teach that there are a plurality of gods in the universe, not just the three separate gods that Mormons worship?
We do believe that there are innumerable gods who have created their own worlds and who are worshipped by their creations.
Yet, the Book of Mormon teaches differently. Read 2 Nephi, chapter 31, verse 21.
"And now behold, my beloved brethren, this is the way, and there is no other way, nor name given under heaven, whereby man can be saved in the kingdom of God. And now behold, this is the doctrine of Christ, and the only true and doctrine of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, which is one God, without end. Amen." I think it means there are three separate members that make up the Godhead.
But that's not what it says. For further clarification, let's read Alma 11, verses 26 and 29.
"And Zizrom said unto him, Thou sayest there is a true and living God. And Amulek said, Yea, there is a true and living God. Now Zizrom said, Is there more than one God? And he said, No." That's interesting.
Pretty clear what the teaching is. There is only one God. Nowhere is a plurality of gods supported by the Book of Mormon. Doesn't modern Mormonism teach that God was once a mortal man who became God, just like all men have the capability to become?
That is what we teach as the plan of eternal progression.
Let me read an excerpt from the book Teachings of the Prophet Joseph Smith, page 345. Quote, "I will go back to the beginning, before the world was, to show what kind of being God is, what sort of being was God in the beginning. God himself was once as we are now, and is an exalted man, and sits enthroned in yonder heavens." End quote.
We believe that.
However, the Book of Mormon, like the Bible, teaches that God is unchangeable. Please read Mormon 9, verse 9 and 19.
"For do we not read that God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, and in him there is no variableness, neither shadow of changing? And if there is miracles wrought then, why has God ceased to be a God of miracles, and yet be an unchangeable being? And behold, I say unto you, he changeth not. If so, he would cease to be God, and he ceases not to be God, and he is a God of miracles." That must mean that since he has become God, he is unchangeable and will always be God.
Then let's read Moroni 7:22.
"For behold, God knowing all things, being from everlasting to everlasting."
And read Moroni 8:18.
"For I know that God is not a partial God, neither a changeable being, but he is unchangeable from all eternity to all eternity."
It all boils down to whether or not the Book of Mormon really is the most correct book on earth. If it is, then current Mormonism disagrees with its essential teachings.